Hi, welcome to the Dr. Lam Show. I have Dom Brightmon. He's an award-winning speaker here to talk to us about how to develop a rock-solid positive mental attitude and how to go from crappy to happy. As we know that we have a lot of patients listening who have undergone a lot of stress and they feel really bad, but a lot of healing is also in mental health and how to be have more optimism about their health. And because when you think happy, you will also be happy and your physical health will also improve, right? So Dom is the author of Going North and Tips and Techniques to Advance Yourself, and also Stay the Course, Elite Performance, Seven Secret Keys to Sustainable Success. And also he has his upcoming book, Crappy to Happy, Sacred Stories of Transformational Joy, which I would love to talk to you about. So welcome, Dom, to the Dr. Lam Show. Tell me a little just about yourself and how you've come to this whole journey that you've been on.
Sure thing. Thank you, Dr. Lam, of course, for having me on your show. Appreciate the work that you and the rest of your team do at your clinic as well, because healthcare workers are freaking heroes in this time of crisis that we can't seem to escape.
I know. It's pretty crazy right now. All the prayers out there.
Yep. But the good thing about crazy, we can turn them into moments of really becoming champions, because the thing about crisis, it allows you to become the champion that you're meant to be. And that's kind of how I got to where I am currently today, because a little bit about myself. I grew up a church boy in the wonderful land of charm, crime, and crab cakes, known as Baltimore, Maryland, US of A. Yeah, we do love crab cakes. We do love being charming. And of course, as with all big cities, crime is going to happen. But hey, it's not all about the crime. I usually try to talk about the Baltimore Ravens and the Baltimore Orioles. But growing up in that wonderful city, having two lovely parents, a father who was a veteran who fought in World War II and then the Korean War, and a loving mother who got a master's degree in psychology, who was all about making sure that she helped as many people as she can, especially learning as much as she can as a result. And her being my first ever real unofficial slash official public speaking coach slash life coach, and taking her example and what she's given me to be able to really use my voice and to continue to use it and to help others using it as well. Just doing some stuff in church growing up and getting into college, taking a public speaking course, then Toastmasters International, where I truly had the opportunity to not only develop my messages, but also help other people and get a nice sandbox opportunity to practice leadership in a volunteer organization.
Yeah, that's great. Whatever you've learned, you're trying to teach other people too, right? So that's a great principle to learn from. So having grown up, in, like you said, in crime land, how do you develop or become strong, or how do you use your mental attitude, and how do you teach people to get over their environment? Because sometimes people are under really stressful environments. How would they change their mental attitudes to be able to adapt to them?
Powerful question right there. Powerful question, because it's so darn true. A lot of our success depends on the environment that we're in and how you act in that environment. Kind of like with the concrete jungle, for those who may live in concrete jungles, it's best to try to swing through them if you don't actually live in them. And if you live in them, you basically have to make sure you find pockets of peace that you can. So one thing I like to advise people to do is try to find your pockets of peace, because every single day we're gifted with 24 hours. No matter how rich or poor you are, we still have 24 hours in a day, 7 days in a week. And we have the same amount of time, but what you do with that time is going to separate you from the rest of the world. And those that are elite performers, they know how to get the most out of their day, and they direct their attention throughout the day to the areas that help them to be the best they can. And if you can find your own pocket of peace, if that's 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 or 30 minutes a day, silent meditation, some deep breathing, or just doing something that you love, that'll help you out, especially if you can find a pocket of production as well, where you dedicate time for some self-improvement, like with you in the medical field, I'm pretty sure you have to stay up to date with all the crazy stuff going on and all the wonderful opportunities that are out there for maybe, especially with integrative medicine, I'm pretty sure there's different things that you may not get in certain places. So yeah, you got to stay on the cutting edge of everything. Mm-hmm. So having not only a pocket of peace for yourself, but also a pocket of productivity and production time where you're doing something to also better yourself as well. Because even though your environment is powerful and you want to try to make sure your environment is really setting up for success, if you're not there yet fully, have those two pockets in your life throughout the days, every day, and try to schedule them if you can, especially if you can get them the same time of day, if you can, that'll really put you at so your words, the cutting edge of your life and being the best version of yourself.
That's great. Yeah. To set aside that time, right. To be able to find that pocket of peace, I think is important. A lot of times our patients or people listening to us, they are go-getters. They are type A people that just want to go, 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 back to back. Their whole day is filled. And so I like how you said to be able to schedule that time aside to do something you love or to just breathe. And breathing is so important to bringing down that sympathetic response of our go, go, go life and just, get grounded and say, hey, why am I doing this? What are my goals? What am I happy about? And what are my joys in life, right? And so finding that pocket of peace is really important. And if you don't have 30 minutes, you can change it into a habit. Like people practice mindfulness, for example. Like for me, in between patients that I see, I just take a moment and I take a deep breath to kind of cleanse the previous patient so that I'm present for the current patient, right? And so that's also another way of developing that mental attitude for each, that you're setting aside your time intentionally for each person. Do you have any other tips on how to develop this rock solid positive mental attitude, especially for people who their environment is very stressful, their relationships are stressful? What are ways that they can set aside this time or other ways of changing their mental attitude?
Sure thing. So I got these four magical keys for crappy to happy, and I like to call it the RAVE method, RAVE. So the R in RAVE stands for reading great material. And the thing about reading, if you're able to read, is the beautiful thing is you get to explore different worlds. Your mind gets to explore, and they give your mind a break if you're reading something in the fiction category. Heck, even if those listening, if they love reading romance novels, if that's your thing, go on ahead, do your thing, like whatever's good for you. If you like a good self-help book or a good leadership book like myself, that'll empower you and feel like charged up. Like sometimes I've read some great books that have like energized me. Heck, even one of those books is a book by a Japanese businessman, Kazuo Inamori, and the book was titled A Compass to Fulfillment. Like that book in particular, just like reading the first few chapters of that book, I still remember, I think it was like 5 years ago I first read that book, and I just felt energized and ready to just take on the world after that. So just reading great material, especially from folks who know how to really put their voice and their personality into their words and their writing, that way it can influence you, because a book is a piece of immortality that someone has put out there, whether it's their research or their actual lives, heck, even biographies like that as well. So like reading great material is another thing that I love to do to really get out of that point. I recommend that for everybody. And for those that say they don't have time to read, it's like, hey, that could be in your pocket of productivity / your pocket of production time, where you're doing something that'll actually help benefit you.
Right. And the education, I always say, it's really key to even healing, because you have to have knowledge in order to know what to do with your health. A lot of times we just we defer to the doctor to know everything, but sometimes the doctor might not know. You have to definitely be an advocate. And in order to be an advocate for your own health, you have to read and have that knowledge, that knowledge base, right, to know what your health is about. So I like that. R for reading. And then what's A for?
Yes, A is for audio immersion. So these wonderful ear headphones I have or earbuds or AirPods that folks walk around with nowadays so they don't have to worry about cords and whatnot. Just basically immersing yourself in great audio material. So this podcast is definitely in that category already. Listening to a great audiobook, heck, even one person I recommend is Dr. Allison J.K. She's a wonderful doctor who does these, she calls them clearings. I like the way she does it. It's like reverse affirmation. So if any of your listeners or you in particular may have had been through a guided meditation where you're actually being guided through some breathing activity and some subconscious programming, like her clearing her audio programs are similar to that, but in a different way. It's basically taking the negative, like stuff, like even if you want to generate an abundance mentality, the classic phrase like, oh, money is the root of all evil and I got to avoid it. Yes, but she says that first, and then it says like money loves me and money is a great tool to advance me forward. Yes. So basically just taking the negative connotation, saying it first, what your mind may be programmed to think, then saying no afterwards, and then programming your mind to think in a different way afterwards. Because that's one of the things, because we learn through the five senses, what we see, hear, taste, touch, or smell. And of course, the hearing is the most important piece, especially for those who may not be able to see. What you hear is what you're eventually going to become. So that's why audio immersion is number two in this RAVE method, because it's great. It's always great to read some great material, but also what you listen to is important, because what you listen to is what you'll eventually become. Heck, even words are powerful too. I'm sure you probably remember some times where you've had a great mentor, great teacher, or great family member that said some encouraging words to you, Dr. Lam, and that really helped you to go on for a lifetime and keep reaching for more. And there's probably some times where someone may have said something negative to you that you still remember from probably decades ago, even if it's been 10 or 15 years. So that's why audio immersion is number two. And that's why you should focus on things that you listen to that are better for you, that'll actually benefit you.
And for people who can't coach, that's why we started this Dr. Lam show, the podcast, so that it can really reach so many more people to empower, to educate through not only reading articles that we have, but also, yes, to listen to them, right? It's much easier to listen sometimes when you're on a drive or in traffic or you're on a walk. It's much safer to listen than to read, right? So that's great. RA, and then what does the V stand for in RAVE?
Yes, the V in RAVE stands for visual stimulation. Visual stimulation. Like our wonderful eyes, they can capture over a billion images all at once through these wonderful eyes that we have. That's another reason why a lot of logos stick out, like the Nike swoosh. Like you see that swoosh, you think of Nike, the McDonald's, the big fat golden arches, the M, McDonald's, Starbucks. You're going to see the darn green mermaid on the cup. It's like, oh, yeah, that's Starbucks, without even seeing the word Starbucks on the cup. Our eyes are built for capturing images, and images can stay in our minds for a long time. And if you can have that wonderful vision within your mind to basically push you forward and manifest into a future truth, then you definitely have power. We all have that power through the power of image and the power through visualization. And also, it also depends on what we decide to put in front of our eyes on the daily, like with YouTube, the TV, the smartphone. Like the wonderful thing about the smartphones that we have access to so many things. Also, the bad part about the smartphone, we have access to so many things and we can get trapped in the scrolling our life away. When you're scrolling your life away through just looking through whatever you're scrolling through, like if it's actually through YouTube, which is great, there's great content on there. I use YouTube on the daily for entertainment and educational purposes, but also social media as well. Like sometimes if you do too much of that, then that'll be all that's on your mind, as opposed to you actually taking some time out, doing some self-visualization and having an image in your mind that you hold within your mind that you want to manifest as a future truth for your life. So visual stimulation is the V in RAVE method. So basically reading great material, having great audio, listening to great stuff every day, and making sure that your eyes are focused on something positive every day, whether it's flowers, your own garden, heck, even if you're growing vegetables in your own food garden, something positive, because this mind is a garden we have to tend to daily. And with this wonderful attention management era we're in, where everything's vying for your attention, make sure that your eyes are basically attending to things that'll benefit you and those around you in the future. So that way you won't have to pull out as many weeds, metaphorically speaking.
That's true. If you see it every day, you're not going to have to wait a few months to pull out the weeds. And I love how you you said vision is not only physically seeing stuff, but it's a visual. Like, what is your vision for the future? What do you see yourself becoming? And how do you visualize for us? Like, how do you visualize your health and how functional you are, right? Because when you have that vision, then you're definitely going to strive forward towards that. There are actually some studies where they show people do visual and guided imagery before they go into the surgery. So they think about the surgery and how it's going to turn out really well. And it actually has been studied to have lower blood loss and have been much better outcomes when people actually visualize the surgery ending up well and doing well. And so that's amazing how vision and can really make a difference in your health and your outcome. Awesome. So that's great. What's next? Yeah.
Yes, the bottle cap for everything, or the thumb to put it on the hand. The E is for encouragement, encouraging yourself and others. And there's a reason why I say encouraging yourself and others, because one of the most things that we tend to forget, and another reason why self-care is so preached a lot nowadays, is because sometimes you have to encourage yourself before you encourage others. And sometimes you have to remember to encourage others, so that way you too can be encouraged yourself. Because like the classic metaphor, when you light another candle with your candle, you don't lose your flame. They gain some fire too, and you don't lose any of yours. So that classic analogy ties in perfect with encouragement, because if someone's living and breathing, they need encouragement. I still remember one time in particular, it was years ago, like it was like a test I had to take for a professor. And he was like, "Hey, Dom, you ever got an A on one of my tests before?" Because this was like going to be like a short test for like Bible. I had those Bible classes back in the day. And I was like, "Nah, Mr. Lay never did." And he's like, "Hey, how about if you get a perfect score on this test, I will buy your lunch the next day if you actually pass this test." And he saw that I could do it, because one, there wasn't a lot of content for this test, which is out of the norm for him. And two, he figured, hey, you have the gift within you to do it. You probably just need the proper bribery or the proper encouragement. So my belly got full afterwards. I got a perfect score of that test, because that was the power of encouragement. And just heck, even power of really just knowing your audience too. It's like, hey, who doesn't like free food as a growing boy? Hey. So yeah.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree that encouragement is huge in healing and helping a mental attitude, and even in relationships and getting to where you need to get to, right? We've done telemedicine, and it's basically to encourage our patients to participate in their own health, to gain education, to find out what's at the root cause of their problems and get better. And all this is through encouragement, like you said, with this big E. And we even found that we've done these fatigue group classes, where we have a support groups that come together and they encourage each other, because sometimes they don't need just a doctor telling them what to do. They need each other, and everyone is going through the same issues. So it's very encouraging to see them talking to each other and supporting each other, right? So that's great. So we've learned a lot about the RAVE, four keys to optimism, right? From going to crappy to happy. And just to reiterate, the R was for reading. And then the A was for audio. The V was for visual learning. And then the E was for encouragement, right? Did I get it right?
You got it right. Four-pack abs for Dr. Lam, baby. Congrats.
Thank you. Oh,
she's got it, baby. She's got it.
Yeah. So, Dom, thank you so much for this this learning and for this encouragement. And how do people find you if they wanted to get a hold of you?
One of the best parts of video and Zoom backgrounds, I could just point above my head to dombrightmon.com. Head over to dombrightmon.com and be sure to subscribe to the Going North podcast, where the goal is to interview over 1,000 authors across the globe to get their stories out there and live my motto, advance others to advance yourself. And check it all out on dombrightmon.com if you want to learn more about Dom. And if this is your first time listening to Dr. Lam's show, be sure to subscribe for more content, especially here. Wonderful advice about the gut health too.
Oh yeah, definitely got it. So like, subscribe. We'll see you at our next episode.